Thanks to 23andMe for sponsoring this video. More about them later. I'm late for work.
This is how we do it down in Puerto Rico. I just wanna hear you screaming, ay bendito. I can move forever cuando esté contigo. Pasito, pasito, suave, suavecito. Nos vamos pegando poquito, poquito.
Just got home and Meredith has already put me to work. But we're working on something that's for the vet clinic. So actually Meredith is working for me right now. I just got a bunch of new targets in. Wanted to say thanks. Halfcock Target sent me these. I painted these colors. They're kind of ridiculous colors, but they come unpainted. They sit in the ground. This thing is like a stake, so you stick it in the ground. These things are angled forward a little bit. What are you making there, Meredith?
A picture frame.
So Mare and I took this beautiful picture on Easter Sunday, and we're gonna hang this up in the vet clinic. So Mare's making a 2x4 frame. It's cheap, it's easy, it looks nice. Does it not fit? It's so close. If this doesn't fit, everyone on the internet is gonna say that I am the better one at Construction Ranch. No, I feel like even if this doesn't fit, they'll still say I'm worse. Like a glove. Now we have to take it out, sand it, stain it, and then put something to hang it with, I guess, huh?
Yeah, I have all that.
It's going in the waiting room of the clinic. Good job, Mayor. Are you really happy about how much I helped you with this project?
Yeah.
I am such a hard worker. Hey, Mayor.
Yeah.
Unbeknownst to you, I just did a Twitter post saying, ask Mayor anything. Ready?
What?
So now people have some questions for you. The first question is from Sean, marry me? Question mark.
That might be a problem.
We do get lots of questions asking, is my wife single? Which I think is kind of funny. Do you like having guns in the house?
Yes.
Feel safe?
Yeah.
If you could have any animal, fictional or not, tamed as a pet, what animal would you have?
I have no idea. Something really big.
Like a unicorn?
Sure.
What do you dislike the most about Matt? Be careful here.
These are hard questions.
I'll close my ears for a second. Okay, I can't hear you. You can say it.
I don't know.
Okay, good. Nothing? Would you say you don't dislike anything about me? Don't like your silence. All right, next question. Are you the boss of Matt?
Definitely.
That's true. Do you like pineapple on pizza?
I love pineapple on pizza.
Have you had to take away any guns from Matt? Who's your biggest celebrity crush besides Matt? Because it's like a pat on my back, too.
Besides Matt? Bradley Cooper?
Bradley Cooper, that's true.
You do like him.
How does Matt deserve someone so cute like you? No disrespect, Matt. That's very disrespectful.
He doesn't.
Dear Mayor, what do you do for a living? Also, you guys are the best. Love ya.
He's a civil engineer.
She went to college, Texas A&M, got a civil engineering degree, and worked while I went to vet school. She put me through vet school. She paid all of our bills while I was spending our money at school. Does Mayor trust Matt with his huge collection of guns in the house? Annie just said no. Mayor actually told me one time if I ever accidentally fire a gun in the house, I have to get rid of all my guns.
That is true. So that rule still stands. I know that he's fired a gun in the house.
But she said if I accidentally fired a gun, so we're good. How did you and Matt meet?
In high school.
Calculus class.
I think it was history.
Yeah, it was history, actually. World history.
10th grade.
What is your best animal noise you can make?
Yes!
I do not make animal noises.
Well, make your best.
Nope, it doesn't happen.
Just do a cow.
Nope.
Do a mare. You're a mare. Do a mare.
Nope.
Can you just make a pig noise? Why have we not seen more of you shooting things? They just got a video like last week of you shooting things.
And I kicked Matt's booty.
Shut it. What do you like most about Matt? I'm kind of hilarious all the time. Has Matt ever done something so ridiculous for a video that you were legitimately pissed at him? I don't like bringing this stuff up.
Oh, the bug. That's the only time I can think of. But I was really mad.
Yeah, she was not very happy about the bug. She's still not very happy about that bug. When will Mayor build the hen house?
We're working on that.
I actually just ordered it, and I thought it was gonna be here in like 2 weeks. It's gonna take like 4 to 6 weeks. So we're gonna have to build them like a little like shack to live in, because they're getting too big. We need to build like a shack to get them through the next couple of months until we get the real legit hen house. Who is your favorite kid? Oh, that looks really good.
Yeah, you're welcome.
But who's your favorite kid?
Who's my favorite kid?
Me.
Me.
How many times has Matt said he'd be home at a certain time, but was late because of shooting?
A head block.
Pretty much like twice a week.
Nope.
It's true.
What are you doing?
Just recording myself. Hello. Has Matt ever attempted something so crazy that you had to put your foot down and say no?
No, because when he has ideas that he thinks I would say no to, he just doesn't tell me about them until they're...
That's true. Have you ever heard that it's easier to ask forgiveness than to ask permission? That's kind of what I live by. What is your favorite way to annoy Matt? Do people have favorite ways to annoy their spouses? Do you have a favorite way?
No, I don't think I ever intentionally...
Yeah, you're just like, man, which way am I going to annoy Matt today? I'll do my favorite way. All right, this is a great question because it's something that I've wanted to bring up to you anyway. Which way do you put the toilet paper on the holder? Over the top or the wrong way?
I have no idea.
That's the problem.
I do it differently.
You do it halvesies, and it's so annoying.
I'm sorry.
I'm glad that we're able to bring this to light.
Jeez.
It needs to go over the top. Thank you, Justin Johnson. You're the man. We have a 6-year-old filming, and she's filming the ceiling. This episode is sponsored by 23andMe.com. 23 refers to there are 23 pairs of chromosomes, and so this is a DNA genetic test to find out something about your traits, about your ancestry, and just your genetics in general. And we have two of them, Meredith. One for me, and one for you.
Oh, cool.
You didn't know that?
No.
You can also tell about your facial features, your hair, your taste preferences, your sleep quality, caffeine consumption. Like, it tells you how likely you are to be someone who consumes a lot of caffeine, or like why you might be someone who consumes a lot. Do you know anyone who might be like that, Meredith? I feel like you might know somebody. It talks about saturated fats and like how likely you are to accumulate saturated fats, or how likely you are to like have that desire for caffeine. It'll kind of tell you, right? Apparently there's a genetic base to that, which I did not know.
Awesome.
So now you have something to blame it on.
Now I have an excuse.
Yeah. You're like, sorry, babe, I had to
Had to drink 7 Cokes. It's genetic. We do genetic tests at the vet clinic for, like, figuring out certain diseases on dogs or figuring out their breed. Like, we get mutts in and the owners want to know what they are, so we'll do a genetic test, but it's blood. We take a blood sample. This is just... Are you bored?
No, I'm just tired. I need some more caffeine.
This is just spit. So all you do is spit, and there's enough enough cells that they can get your DNA out of your spit, which is pretty crazy. I didn't know that. And then you pose it. Just like that. Excellent.
Put it in the mail.
Mother's Day is coming up soon, and it'd be really cool if you got a kit for yourself and for your mom, because then you could use that the DNA results to compare yours against your mom, the similarities and the differences. That'd be pretty neat. And if you do it before Mother's Day and use our URL, which is 23andme.com/offtheranch, you get $20 off. So thank you, 23andMe, for the sponsor. Thank you guys for checking them out. Done?
Done.
We're now on our way up to the vet clinic, my second time of the day. We're gonna hang up pictures.
Got it. It's pretty. I like it.
More down the left. That looks pretty straight. This is what happens when I bring my kids to work. Pretty good. You like it? I love it. Get in the truck! No rocks in the truck.
Why?
Because, why do you need a rock in the truck? Cause? Thanks for hanging with me today. I had a very productive day, which always makes me happy. And what I want to say has to do with that. There are a lot of YouTubers, a lot of very big, very influential YouTubers, who talk about being happy. And they say, you know, they talk about being positive. And they say, just be happy. Just kind of turn that frown upside down. Be happy. Be positive. Look at the glass like it's half full. And you'll feel better. It'll wash your blues away. But I don't think they're wrong. Let me just say that. They're not wrong. That is a good way to think, but I think they're only telling you like 5% of the formula to be happy. Just saying you're happy, I don't think, is going to make you happy. It's going to help. At least it's not going to hurt, but it's not going to actually make you happy. What I have found is it's not that easy. There's a lot more stuff that goes into it to be happy. And what I think you need to do, I'm not a professional in this, but I feel like I've reached a point in my life where I'm pretty happy with everything, with my family, with my business. And what I think made me this way, made me happy in general, is a lot of little things that added up to this. Every day, try to put yourself in a better position than you were the day before. And I've said it before, work out a little bit, because you're going to be a little bit stronger the next day. Study a little bit, because you're going to be a little bit smarter the next day. Save a little bit of money, because tomorrow you'll have a little bit more money if you save that money. And those little bits don't matter at all in a small time frame. But over a large time frame, you've been working out a little bit for months, you're going to see muscle changing. You're going to see fat burning. You study a little bit for months, you're going to go, hey, I get this. I learned a second language, or I know calculus now. You save a little bit of money for months or years, and you're going to say, oh, I have enough money to start a new business. I can do it now. I don't have to go into debt to do this, or I have enough money to buy my house with no debt. These little things pay off, and they make you happy. When I got out of school, I had $60,000 worth of debt. School loans. Just school loans. And standing there and looking up at $60,000 worth of debt, I was like, how am I ever going to pay this off? And so I realized I was on a 10-year plan to pay off that debt. And I realized if I'm doing this, I'm going to be like 35 before I'm out of this debt. And I was like, no, I don't want this debt forever. And so I started paying extra. Every month, Meredith and I would like scrimp and save, and like we would eat cheap and we would not eat out, because we're like, let's get rid of this debt. Let's kill this debt. And we did. And we paid it off in 2 years. We worked really, 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 really hard and saved all of our money and lived a lot smaller than we could have lived because we wanted to pay off that debt. And it made me happy. It took us 2 years. I couldn't just like say, hey, I have a bunch of debt, but I'm happy today. I'm happy. I wasn't. But I worked hard and I paid it off. So work hard a little bit every day. A tiny amount is better than no amount. Do something, a little bitty thing every day that makes you better tomorrow, that makes your future self better, and you will find happiness. I promise. I love you. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.
We're not talking about killing people.
Just say I want to murder you. Oh. I can't work like this.